The motorcycle right in front of you is the Hero Passion Pro, and it is the second highest selling motorcycle in its category. And on my left, I have the TVS Jupiter, which is again the second highest selling scooter in its category. In today's video, we are not comparing these two motorcycles, but answering a simple question. Should you buy a motorcycle, or are you better off with a practical option like a scooter? Well, the choice is up to you, but in MotorBeam's way, we are going to do some tests. Before we begin that, subscribe to MotorBeam and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Now, the Jupiter is a proper practical scooter because you get multiple storage spaces. And if I talk about the styling, well, this one hasn't had a major update, but there is a major change in the instrument cluster because this has become completely analog and the digital unit has gone away. If I talk about the Passion, here you get a digital cluster, but you don't get much information on offer. It's an analog digital display unit. If I talk about the complete styling, Jupiter has not had a major update, but the Passion has got a very major update. But why am I talking about the styling? Because that is not the reason people buy the scooter or motorcycle. They buy for the reason of practicality, and we are going to do those exact tests like comfort and all of that. So let's begin. Let's start off with a traditional slalom test. The scooter gets off nicely. While it has a smaller wheelbase, it completes the course very quickly. Next up is the bike with a longer wheelbase. It hence takes more time to complete the same, and it is slightly slower than the scooter. But things are about to get interesting. As for real life riding, you do have a pillion and I have got one too. Let's go. The handlebar does get a little heavy and it gets difficult to slalom with a pillion. And damn, I almost touched the last cone. We'll do the same with the bike as well. And this time, the bike seems to be quicker. At the end, with or without pillion, the bike has a similar time. While the scooter becomes a tad bit difficult. Time for bad roads. It does get quite bouncy on the scooter, and the bounce back effect is just way too much. The bike takes the bad roads better because of the better suspension setup, and this time again, the bike wins.
So the Jupiter does not get a disc brake at the front while the Passion gets it. So we are not going to doing a braking test because it will be biased towards the Passion or maybe the Jupiter. But both the two wheelers get sync braking technology or integrated braking technology. So once you apply the rear, the front applies too. Well, we have done a braking test in a previous video, a previous comparo, and the link is right over here.
Now you have a pillion and he's got some luggage to carry. Well, it's a bit tedious, but we manage. I guess we don't. Okay. And it's time to switch. Scooter comes into the picture and a pillion is happy. The footboard area is spacious and can accommodate some luggage as well. And thanks to the strong underbone chassis, it carries the weight without bothering. Scooter wins here while the pillion is happy too. Now one fine day, you don't have a pillion to carry your second bag. On the bike, you became the luggage holder yourself. Tiring, isn't it? Same on the scooter is just so much better. Plus, the extra luggage space does make things easier, like to carry a water bottle in such hot conditions. Scooter is just a bit more practical machine, and now it's a tie. We'll be right back.
Yes, Raskala, I am wearing a lungi. I look dapper, I know. This look represents that women who prefer wearing saris and one-piece long dresses can ride the scooter too without worrying. But for the bike, it's a bit limited.
You know, DOP puts me to so many places that I'm doing farming right now. But to answer that final question, after our test, which one should you buy? Our tests were pretty clear, but if you want a final answer, if you want something that has a good mileage, it is quite comfortable, you should get yourself a motorcycle and a 110cc commuter at a price of 80,000. Well, this is the one for you. But if you want something for your family that is a lot more practical, has a good amount of storage space, and if you want to just move around within the small city limits, well, you should get yourself a scooter, because that is ready for your family, for yourself as well. And for that note, it is time to end. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked our test. And if you liked it, do hit the like button. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.